constant volume cycle, because here the heat addition process takes place at constant volume. Next, Otto cycle is used for spark ignition, that is SI. Spark ignition are also called as petrol engines. So Otto cycle is used for petrol engines, that is to compare the efficiency of actual petrol engine with the standard, and that standard petrol engine would be based on Otto cycle. Now I'll write down the processes. The processes which take place in Otto cycle are, the processes are, first process 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic compression. Next, process 2 to 3, it is constant volume heat addition. So now process 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition, then process 3 to 4 is reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic expansion. Process 4 to 1 is constant volume heat rejection. Now, once we have understood that there are four processes in Otto cycle, these four processes can be shown on PV and TS diagram. PV, that is pressure and volume, TS, temperature and entropy diagram for Otto cycle. It is a graph. Here we have PV, and here is TS diagram, that is pressure volume and temperature entropy diagram. So the first process was reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic compression. Isentropic compression can be shown on PV diagram in this manner. Now here I have process 1, 2, 2, and since it is reversible isentropic compression, so during the compression process volume decreases. So as we see at point 1, that is V1, the volume is more. At point 2, the volume is less. So it is reversible isentropic compression. Then the second process was constant volume heat addition. So constant volume, so from point 2 up till point 3, the volume will remain constant, that is at point number 3, and heat gets added, so pressure also increases here. Next, we can see the volume of point 2 and point 3, they are same, so V2 is equal to V3, as it is constant volume process. Next, process 3 to 4 is reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic expansion. So again, the expansion process will follow a curve from point 3 to 4. This is reversible isentropic expansion, we can say. That is at point 3 the volume was less, at point 4 the volume will be greater. And after the expansion process there is constant volume heat rejection. So here heat it is rejected keeping the volume as constant from 4 to 1. So V1 is equal to V4. Now again I'll explain the processes. Process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. Now the same processes can be shown on TS diagram as well. Here also, first process is isentropic compression. So for process 1 to 2, the entropy remains constant, that is S1 is equal to S2, isentropic compression. Next, the heat addition process is at constant volume. So here I'll show the constant volume line. So heat is added from point 2 to 3, and this line which I have drawn, it indicates a constant volume line, because volume at point number 2 and point number 3 are same. Next, for process 3 to 4, since it is isentropic expansion, so like isentropic compression, here entropy remains constant but the temperature was increasing during the compression process. During expansion, entropy should remain constant but temperature should drop. So here we have point 4, which is at this location we have S3 is equal to S4, entropy remains constant and temperature is dropped, so this is expansion process. And after that, the heat rejection process is at constant volume heat rejection. So again, from 4 to 1, the heat rejection process would be shown, and this line is a constant volume line because the heat is rejected in constant volume. And now we have to take care that while drawing for the diagram, that is TS diagram for Otto cycle, the constant volume lines, they are of diverging nature, that is they go on increasing. That care we have to take. These lines, they are not exactly parallel, they are of diverging nature. So here we have to show that during the compression process, work is input to the air, or we can say air is compressed. From 2 to 3, there is heat addition taking place. So heat is given to the air, heat is going inside. Next, during 3 to 4, we are getting expansion, that is work output from the engine. So that is work done during expansion. Next, from 4 to 1, the heat is rejected. So here heat would be rejected out of the air. Next, same thing from 1 to 2, as we can see here, there is compression. So W suffix C, work input during compression. From 2 to 3, heat is added at constant volume. So it is QA. For 3 to 4, there is work output from the engine, which is during expansion process, so WE. From 4 to 1, we can say heat is rejected from the air. So now here I have shown the PV and TS diagram for Otto cycle. Next, I'll write down the efficiency formula. Therefore, efficiency of Otto cycle is given by efficiency of Otto is equal to 1 minus 1 upon R suffix C raised to gamma minus 1, where R suffix C, it is called as compression ratio, and that compression ratio is given by the formula. It is cylinder volume upon, or it is a ratio of cylinder volume upon clearance volume. So if we see in the diagram, from 0 to 1, that is V1 is the cylinder volume and clearance volume is up to V2. So compression ratio is V1 by V2, and RC, that is compression ratio, will always be greater than 1. And gamma, it is called as adiabatic index whose value is 1.4. So in this video we have seen what is meant by auto cycle along with its efficiency and PV and TS diagram.